here in this latest bit of coding is I set up a couple more lines. And what I just did just quickly is I said, well, what if I wanted to test, right up here I tested a string. So I had a string that I compared to telecom. But what if I wanted to test an integer value? You know, for example, inside of the stock you have an IPO quantity, which is of type integer. There's a different series of comparison operators that pertain to integers. And those symbols have to do with less than, or less than or equal to, or equal to. Now, so let's go ahead and run this one. Now, my IPO quantity here is going to be 5 million, I believe. Or is it 50 million? Two, three, it's 50 million. That's quite a bit. And so if my IPO quantity matches 50 million, then I'm going to say so, you know, just for whatever that scenario is. But if it's less than or equal to that limit of 1,000, then it will say the IPO quantity falls within the limit, and then we'll state what the limit is. And that limit will be 1,000. So if I want to test it as less than my limit, or if it's less than or equal to my limit, you know, or if it was equal to 1,000, or if it was right equal to this. So we'll go ahead and evaluate that. And you realize that it read the final evaluator. Your IPO quantity is equal to that. Now, if I were to say, well, what if your IPO quantity is greater than the limit? What's interesting is that it will execute this statement before, and it will never get to these ones. So my IPO quantity exceeds that limit of 1,000. And that's just because of this symbol. So let's chain that back. And then what if we reversed that symbol so that it was greater than right there? And then it's reading IPO limit falls within the limit. And I don't like that. There's a lack of space right there. So let's go ahead and make that. So we can. And then what if it is less than or equal to 50 million? Your IPO quantity. So it reaches that final test. But we can prohibit it from getting to that final test if one of our conditions happens to match. So it won't go on. It will just stop once we find a match, because we can have infinite numbers of else ifs. Now, one way to end this series of tests, we can say, what if nothing else matches? You know, we end up with this kind of base default. And why don't we change this value so that it's 5,000,001? And maybe that doesn't meet any of the combinations right here. I'm not checking it very carefully, but it's less than. It's going to fail all three of these. And then it should only evaluate properly to that last condition. Greater than or equal to the limit. Yep, that's true. So why don't we just change that just for an experiment, and we'll say, sorry, nothing matched right there. So here's something I want you guys to try to do, is to try to do little tiny experiments with your code that help you learn little bits about the language. But what we've talked about here are just these comparison operators for integers. And we tested that against the integer value of IPO quantity instead of stock.